Welcome to another iYehu tutorial. Today, we'll be talking about creating your first eyeShare self-service workflow. iYehu eyeShare is a lightweight IT process automation solution that enables IT teams to effectively manage their daily activities related to IT operations, from simple, repetitive IT tasks to complex processes across multiple systems. We're excited to announce that iYehu eyeShare now includes a self-service engine that allows you to generate workflows yourself and expose them to end users via a web GUI automatically generated by eyeShare. Let's see how that works. First, we'll create a workflow to create a user in Active Directory, appropriate for use in the self-service workflow. We'll go to Workflows next to our Active Directory folder and hit New. This opens a Workflow Designer window. In order to create a new user, we'll have to generate a temporary password. So let's go to Tools, Memory and Functions, and drag over the Generate Password action. If we double-click it, we can make sure the password adheres to our password policy. Next, we'll drag over the Create Active Directory Account action and double-click it. Let's input the data for our new account. Note that the parameters enclosed with the percent sign are not defined here in iShare and will be exposed later on for self-service use. We'll enter the OU, select our Active Directory server, first name, last name, login name, select the password we've generated by typing generate password.password and our email. Check the text box over here to change the password at next login. Next, we ought to take care of two specific scenarios with a condition for successful or failed user creation. For successful user creation, we want to show the status to the user by using the self-service response action. This action is important for the self-service end user to get an indication of the status of the workflow once it's complete. Let's type what we need to in there. If the user wasn't created successfully, we'll respond accordingly with the error message we've received from the Active Directory server. And let's save our workflow. Now, let's move on to create our self-service interface in the self-service designer. We'll go to Self-Service next to our User Management folder and hit New. Type the title of the self-service and select the workflow we just created. Hit Generate Blocks. Generate Blocks loads all the variables we exposed to the self-service in our workflow. On the top left-hand side, you'll see the toolbox with customizable text box, label, and combo box. You can edit these by changing the parameters here at the bottom. Hit OK to create our first self-service. Now, let's browse to the self-service webpage. Log in using our iShare or Active Directory credentials. On the left, you see the same categories we had in the Self-Service tab in the iShare Studio. Let's go to User Management and launch our Onboarding New Employee Self-Service interface. You'll see all the input fields we've exposed for the self-service in the Self-Service Designer. Let's fill out the input fields and hit Submit. Once we hit Submit, the request triggers a workflow in iShare. Once that workflow's finished its run, we'll get the confirmation, exactly as we designed it in the Workflow Designer. The self-service portal works on your smartphone as well. This concludes our iShare self-service video guide. For more information, please contact our support team or visit our website at www.iyehu.com.